8th of June. Malunkaputta said to the Lord, "Sir, as I was meditating, this thought entered my mind. These speculative views about whether the world is infinite or whether the world is finite, whether it is both infinite and finite, whether it is neither infinite nor finite, these speculative views about whether the soul is same as the body or different from it, these speculative views about whether the Tathagata exists after death or whether he ceases to exist or whether he both exists and does not exist or whether he neither exists nor does not exist, these views are not explained by the Lord. They are set aside, ignored. Sir, if you do not explain these views for me, I will leave this training. If you know the answers to these questions, you should explain them to me. And if you don't, then it would be honest to say so." "But Malankaputta, did I ever say to you, 'Come, be my disciple, and I will answer all these questions for you'?" "No, sir." "Then, did you ever say to me, 'I will become your disciple only if you answer all these questions'?" "No, sir." "So, who are you and what is your complaint, you foolish man? If one were to say that they would not become my disciple until all these views had been explained, he might be dead before it could be done. It is as if a man had been shot by a poisoned arrow and his friends might get a doctor to help him. And he might say, 'Wait, I do not want the arrow removed until I know the name of the man who shot it, what caste he is, whether he is short or tall, fat or thin. I do not want the arrow removed until I know whether the bow that shot the arrow was a spring bow, a crossbow or a long bow. I do not want the arrow removed until I know whether it was made from reed, wood or bamboo, or whether the head of the arrow was a carved tooth head, an ordinary head, a jagged head or an iron head." Long before all these questions could be answered, that man would be dead. In the same way, if someone were to say that they would not become my disciple until all these questions about whether the world is infinite or not were answered, they might be dead before it could be done. Living the holy life could not be said to depend upon whether the world is infinite or not, whether it is both infinite and finite, whether it is neither infinite nor finite. Living the holy life could not be said to depend upon whether the soul is the same as the body or different from it, and so on. Whether the world is infinite or not, there is birth, there is aging, there is dying, there is grief, sorrow, suffering, lamentation, and despair, and it is for the ending of this that I teach. Therefore, understand as not explained what has been not explained by me, and understand as explained what has been explained by me. And what has not been explained by me, all these speculative views that you ask about. And why? Because it is not connected with the goal. It is not fundamental to the holy life. It does not conduce to letting go, giving up, stilling, calming, higher knowledge, awakening, or to nirvana. And what has been explained by me, the Four Noble Truths, and why? Because it is connected with the goal. It is fundamental to the holy life. It does conduce to letting go, giving up, stilling, calming, higher knowledge, awakening, and to nirvana.